Let's move on and solve some questions based on compound interest and simple interest. The first question is, what amount is to be repaid on loan for rupees 12,000 for one whole 1/2 years at 10% per annum compounded half yearly? Please make a notice, the interest is calculated compound interest. That is clear with the question? Here they are mentioning particularly that they are calculating the interest on half yearly basis. That means whatever rate of interest was provided, the rate of interest was per annum. That is, that was for the period of whole 12 months. But here we are calculating the interest on half yearly basis. That means our interest will get reduced to half. So now the principal that we have is rupees 12,000. The rate of interest for half yearly purposes will remain 5% and the time period would be 3.5 years. Clear? Now let me introduce you with another formula for calculating amount directly. The other way is, I will be solving it from both the ways, but I want you to understand this formula as well. So let us discuss. The formula says amount is equal to the principal into 1 plus rate upon 100 raised to power n. So over here the principal is 12,000 in brackets 1 plus 5 over 100 raised to power 3. This solves equal to 12,105 upon 100 raised to power 3. Further solving would get me 13891.50 as the amount for 3.5 years, right? But now let us check our answer the other way that we used to solve. For first principal would remain the same, that is 12,000. The time period is 3.5 years, right? So I can write the time period as 1/2 for each case, right? Now the rate of interest would remain 5%. Let us calculate the simple interest for 1 year. For first year, the simple interest would be 12,000 into 5 into 1/2, or you can, here you would don't need to write 5. Why? Because I'm already making the time period as half. If I'm not making the time period half, I can make the rate 5%. That depends. A whole upon 100. Now over here the rate has already reduced to 5. So this solves to 600, because these zeros get cancelled. We get 600 as the interest for first year. Now the amount for the first year would be 12,000 plus 600. Now this solves to 12,600. Now this is the amount for first year. This is going to become my principal for the second year. So let us solve. 12,600 into 10 into again 1/2. How many half years are we taking? 3.5 years. So we have to calculate simple interest for each case. Whole divided with 100. Now 2 and 5 zeros get cancelled. We get the answer as 5 6 is 30, 3 carry, 5 2 is 10 and 3 1, 5 1 is 5 and 6. Now the simple interest is 630. The amount would be 12600 plus 630. Adding it up, we get 13230. Again, for the third year, the simple interest will be calculated with 13230 into 10 into 1/2 upon 100. On solving, we would get 2 6s 12, 2 6s 12, 2 1s 2.5. This is the simple interest. The final amount, or the amount for third year, would be equal to 13230 plus 661.5. That is equal to 13891.50. Now you can yourself make out over here that no matter, even if you use the formula directly, see, that formula actually reduces your time, right? So whenever possible, please try and use the formula itself. That reduces your amount of time expenditure. Now let us move on to the second question. Fabina borrows rupees 12,500 at 12% rate per annum. That means the principal is also provided to us, that is rupees 12,500. The rate is given to us, which is 12%, and time period is also provided to us, which is 3 years. And Radha borrows the same amount for same period at 10% per annum. Now, this was, the data was given for Fabina. We are going to write the data for Radha as well. For Radha, the principal is going to remain the same. That is ₹12,500. For rate of interest has changed to 10% compounded annually, right? Who pays more? Now, the time period is also going to remain the same. That is 3 years. Now, there is one very small difference. For Fabina, the simple interest has been calculated, whereas for Radha, we calculate the compound interest. So, we have to check who pays more and by how much. Let us start calculating. Over here, we have to calculate simple interest. So, let us start. Simple interest would be equal to 10,500 into 12 into 3 over 100. Now, on solving, we get 125 into 36. Now, on solving this, let us get 6 5s are 30, 6 2s are 12, 13, 14, 15 and 1, 6 1s are 6 and 7, 3 5s are 15, 1, 3 2s are 6 plus 1, 7, 3 1s are 3. We get 0, 10, 15 and 4. So, this is the simple interest that Fabina is getting. What will be the amount for her? It would be 12,500 plus 4,500. That would give us the amount 00, 01, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 17,000. Let us try the calculations for Radha now, because she was going to pay the compound interest. So, we will be doing compound interest for her. That means simple interest for first year would be 12,500 multiplied with 10 into 1 upon 100. Zeros get cancelled. The simple interest we get is 1250. The amount for first year would be 1250 plus 12,500. That gives us 05731. Now, this amount becomes the principal for the second year. That would be 13750 into 10 into 1 whole upon 100. Zeros get cancelled. So, the simple interest comes out to be 1375. Again, the amount for second year would be 1375 plus 13750. That would be 5, 7 plus 5, 12, 1 carry, 7 plus 3, 10 and 1, 11, 1, 3, 4 and 1, 5 and 1. That becomes the amount for second year. Again, simple interest for the third year, 15125 into 10 into 1 whole upon 100. Zeros get cancelled. We get 1512.5 as the simple interest. For the amount, we would add this to the principal for the third year. That was 15125. On adding, we would get 15125.0 plus 15125. So, we get 5, 7, 3, 6, 6 and 1. This is the amount that she is going to pay at the end of third year. Now, who is paying higher? Obviously, Fabina is going to pay higher. By how much? You will subtract the values and give the answer. You subtract 16,637.5 out of the 17,000 and you will come to know the value of how much, who has paid more. Let us move on to the third question. It says a TV was bought at a price of ₹21,000. So we can write the cost price or the principal price as ₹21,000 only, right? After 1 year, the value of TV depreciated by 5%. Now the depreciation term here means that the value is getting reduced by 5% after 1 year. So find the value of TV after 1 year. That means simply the value depreciated can be calculated. Value depreciated would be equal to how much? 5% of 21,000. That would be equal to 5 upon 100 into 21,000. On solving, you would get 0, 5, 1, 0, 5, 0 as the depreciating value. Now, after one year, the value that you will be getting would be 21,000 minus 1050, giving you 19950 rupees as the value of the TV. That means even after buying a TV for the first year of at rupees 21,000, after 1 year, if the person wants to resell it, its value get reduced by 5%. So now he would be able to sell the TV at 19,950 rupees.